How would I do it? Okay. This is the same question I asked for the derivative. We all understand the concept, how to formulate it, but can I calculate it? Is it useful? Okay. Now, let us think about it. What I'm doing here, is given the information for velocity as a function of time, if I know the speeds at each moment in time, I am calculating from velocity information, position information. Okay? Now I already know a relation between velocity and position. What was that relation? As we learned last week. How do you find the exact velocity if you are given the position x of t? That's what we learned last week. Take the derivative. So v of t there is the thing that is the derivative of x of t. Okay? We'll use that now. So, how to calculate the integral? That's my problem now. Well, v of t equals dx dt. V of t is the derivative of x. Now in this problem, in this situation, I already know v of t. And I'm asking, what is this v of t the derivative of? Okay? So to calculate the integral, this is what I must answer. I know some function is given to me, such and such a function. This is derivative of something. And what is that something? That's a distance. And that's what I want to calculate. Okay? Let's do an example. V of t is 5t cubed, let's say. X of t is what? Now, please pay attention, I'll ask this to you. Okay. We learned last week that if a function is given as a power of t, then the derivative is also a power, but one less power. Okay? So now we have t cubed. T cube is going to be the derivative of what? Does everybody understand the question? Okay, yeah. It must be the derivative of t to the 4, because when you take the derivative, the derivative is one less power. So I know the derivative of it is t cubed. It's one less than 4. So it must be t to the fourth. Is this enough? Well, if I take the derivative of t to the fourth, I will get not t cubed, but 4t cubed. That's the rule that we learned last week. In fact, we derived it. Okay? I don't want the 4 now. I don't have a 4 there. I have a 5. So I have to divide by this 4. Okay? And I want a 5 there. A constant, when you take a derivative, nothing happens to it, a constant in front. Okay? So whatever constant is there, you keep it there. You increase the power to integrate, and you divide by that new power. How did I figure this out? Well, because I know how to get v from x when I take the derivative. If the v happens to be a power, to get that right power with the right coefficient, the right number in front, you have to get one less power when you take the take the velocity, and you go back, so you have one more power. Okay, so essentially, from the definition of derivative, we have a library, we have a list of all types of functions, and we know what their derivatives are. If you don't know, we can look it up, because we understand where it comes from. And the integral is the thing whose derivative we already know. So you just invert the process. You ask what function it is, whose derivative will give me this. And that's how you work it out, right? Now another question. I almost answered this one. If I put 12 here, I add 12. Is this okay? It is okay, could be. Because if I take the derivative of this thing with the 12 now, 12 is a constant, it does not change, its derivative is 0. So again, I get the derivative is 5t cubed. Does it have to be 12? Anything else that I put there is okay. Any constant, okay? So, I have found that, I've done that example, I'll now generalize it. If I know v of t is given as some constant times t to the power n, I know that x of t has to be the same constant, t to the power what? N plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus, another constant. Now, what is the meaning of this extra constant? Mathematically, it can be anything. In an experiment, I can find out what that constant is. How would I do that? Does anyone have any idea? Well, put in t equals 0. Well, if I consider where was my position at t equals 0, at t equals 0, this term does not contribute at all. Okay? So I have found that x of t is just x of 0